There is indeed no free lunch. I was hoping I was not going to say anything, but Your Excellency, Sultan Al-Anqari, the different representatives of the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, the implementing partners, government officials from the different departments, and the representatives of the beneficiaries. I think I stand up to just say thank you. For indeed, poverty is real. My children would say, Mommy, poverty is a real struggle in the young people's language. And they would say, the struggle is real. So for us as a Department of Social Development, tasked with the responsibility on behalf of government to look after the most vulnerable members of South Africa, we appreciate each and every partnership that contributes to moving our people forward. This particular era has been one of those most challenging, the most difficult, and the most painful. For we've managed as government to reach others, and in the process did not reach others. So a contribution such as this one gives us an opportunity to extend that arm. So we want to say thank you to the Sultan Humanitarian Aid, because 15,000 South Africans from across different religions, different aspects, and I think Councillor Christian also spoke about the different nationalities, which is what makes us human. It's our ability to embrace each other, would really have something to sustain themselves. And we agree in the fact that at least they would be able to cook and eat, and for that particular period, not think about where and how am I going to put a food on the table. So ours is to say thank you, thank you, thank you on behalf of all our beneficiaries that would be benefiting. We stand to just show our sincere appreciation to the people and the government of the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. We also want to say thank you to all of the implementing partners who will be the legs and the hands that will deliver all of this, because it is also not just about the food and the parcel, as we normally put it, it's about how it is going to be delivered and how it is packaged that reinforces inherent dignity. Fighting poverty is a real struggle, and it is one of our aspirations. As social development, we are required to actually create self-sustainable, caring, and reliable communities. And what His Excellency, on behalf of his beautiful country, I must say, I was invited with my husband a few years ago. I'm trying to think, remember the year, but I've been to Saudi Arabia, very beautiful country. So I went to Riyadh, and it was very interesting. We were invited to assist the kingdom with disability policies and disability research so that they can look after and really design programs that are responsive to persons with disabilities. I think it was 2012, yes. And what is interesting that I've witnessed is we went, we shared experiences, we visited. But somehow, even though we were ahead in developing the programs, the policies for persons with disabilities, you've somehow overtaken us. And we look back today, whether it's the project on artificial limbs, especially for children, whether it's the cataract operations, so the prevention of disability and the support for persons with disabilities, you have actually taken all of what we brought to the table and performed it better than us. And we appreciate that particular partnership, Your Excellency. I think as a disabled South African, I always appreciate those countries that don't do humanitarian work as an event, you know, as an activity, but they live it. And I think that is what also makes Islam such an amazing religion, is that you care as a matter of fact. And I think it's some of the things we as Christians can try and learn, some of the values, but also you put people first. So as we say thank you, one of the things, I do read the Quran, I love reading, and I love understanding different spiritual issues. And one of the things I read yesterday, which I was thinking, what am I gonna say when I take the podium, was the fact that showing appreciation to your fellow human being is part of what is built into the Islam as a religion, because you can't thank Allah when you can't see Him and not thank and appreciate or contribute the people around you. So in all of that which will happen and the future partnerships that we are looking forward to as social development, we want to say thank you, thank you, thank you, and do pass our regards and our appreciations to the King for actually making sure that South Africa is amongst the beneficiaries, but also to the management of the center and for making sure that during these difficult times, they actually assist us to feed the ones we are too, you know, limited to reach everyone. So on behalf of the people, the government of the Republic of South Africa, on behalf of social development's immediate beneficiaries, we want to say thank you to yourself, Your Excellency, as the facilitator here in South Africa in making sure the partnership as well as the international relations between our governments, our people, and today, tomorrow, and walking into the future together is what we would like to say. We really appreciate, and we're looking forward to many, many more partnerships in the humanitarian space. Thank you very much.